lot of you appear for the exam and you score good marks but not good enough to get the medical seat. What do you do in that case? You want to take up engineering or you want to take up something else? If you want to become a doctor, it doesn't matter you don't succeed in the first attempt. It's okay. You try again. You don't get it. You try again. You will get it. I didn't get into medical college during my first attempt. And I dropped the exam and I waited for 1 year and applied for it again. And second time I got it. If I didn't get it, I would have waited some more time. Because that's all I wanted to do. I didn't want to do anything else. If you try hard enough, you will get into medical college. When I was a young student like you, there are hardly some 30 medical colleges. Today there are about 500 medical colleges. And every year the medical seats are increasing. So never give up because you didn't get it for the first time. Whether you join the medical college or not, I just want to tell you something about failure. The whole world is teaching you to become successful. But failure is part of your life. The society, when somebody, a kid fails in class, society looks down upon them. And we feel that you may not express your views, but somebody says, I failed the exam, automatically your impression about the person changes. I'll tell you my story. I failed in second standard. I don't think you have ever come across anybody in this world who has failed in second standard. I didn't know what failure was until I failed. And it was a day I could never forget in my life. That's the only thing I remember in my school. Everyone, there are about 50 students in my class. Everyone was asked, one by one, the names were read out. And those names were read out, they stood. In the end, they all walked out. And I was the only kid sitting. And I failed the first time in my life. I joined medical college. I did reasonably well as an undergraduate student. I wanted to become a surgeon. And I appeared for the exam. And I was supposed to be a very good surgical resident. And I failed the exam. And I again appeared for the exam. I passed. Then I went to England. I wanted to be a heart surgeon. But I wanted to appear for the FRCS exam. But I was already a surgeon. It didn't matter whether I passed or failed FRCS. I appeared for the exam. I failed. I appeared for FRCS again. I failed. I appeared for it again. Failed. And four times I failed in FRCS exam. But I was teaching surgeons who have done FRCS how to do the heart operation. Because the examination is not about my skill as a heart surgeon. Examination has nothing to do with how good heart surgeon I am. In the end, my wife refused to pay the fees. So I stopped appearing, but in the end, probably they got fed up and they gave me the FRCS degree. So essentially, just because you have failed, that doesn't mean anything. You fail once, it's okay. You try again, you'll pass. Because in the real life, nobody cares how many times you have failed. People care what you have done with your life. So just because you have failed once or twice, never lose confidence. I want you to go to Google and just ask a question. The successful people who have failed in the exam. You get all the Nobel laureate, most of the famous people who changed the world, you see their name. So you're going to be one of those elitist group of people. So if you failed, don't worry. The beauty of medical profession I am sorry if your parents are listening to me, they may be thinking that Dr. Shetty is teaching my kids to fail, but I can tell you that this is the best lesson what I can teach you. The beauty of medical profession, lot of professions give you lot of money. It's good to have money.